In my previous lectures and discourses, I had covered socialism and capitalism. In the same series, another fundamental expression is communism. What is communism all about? Well, it is theoretical, to some extent philosophical, and partly practical social, political, and economic ideology, and a drive, a movement, whose eventual objective is the institutionalization of a communist society or culture, which is a kind of socioeconomic system of governance designed upon the concepts and notions of common ownership of the resources of production and the absence of social classes, money, and the sharing of, you know, state mechanism. So the underlying feature of a communist society being common ownership of the means of production, with free access to the items of consumption, and is, you know, classless and stateless, inferring or suggesting in a way the end of exploitation or manipulation of labor and workforce. Communism is a definitive phase of socioeconomic growth, an advancement built upon an abundant availability of material wealth and affluence, which is assumed to have evolved from enhancements and advancements in production skills and resultant shifts in the societal dealings of production. This would allow for distribution based on need and social relations based on freely associated individuals. The phrase communist society, however, should be distinguished from the Western model of the communist state. In the Western ideology, there is an existence of state which is socialistic in nature and in profile. A state ruled by a party which propagates a variation from Marxist approach. That's the difference. Communism includes a range of schools of thought, which broadly include Marxism and social anarchism, as well as the political ideologies categorized around both these concepts or ideologies. Interestingly, all of these share the analysis that the current order of society branches out from its economic system, capitalism, that in this system there are two major societal classes, that struggle between these two classes is the root of all problems in society, and that this state of affairs will finally be resolved through a social revolution contained in communism. The two classes are the working class, you know, who must work to survive and who make up the majority within society, and the capitalist class, a minority who derives profit from employing the working class through private ownership of the means of production. The revolution will put the working class in power and in turn establish social ownership of the means of production, which, according to the analysis, is the primary element in the transformation of society towards communism. Well, that is all for today. Please do not forget to subscribe to this channel if you have not already done. It's right there, the red button. Thank you so much for today. Thanks.